This was Chris, my mission companion. 5 years ago, we were separated after it was discovered that we were slightly more than just mission companions. I was immediately sent home, and Chris was allowed to stay in Clackamas Falls. But we kept in touch, and after his mission, we went on a trip across America. We had the time of our lives. For a few months, we weren't Elder Smith and Elder Merrill. We had no obligations and no pressure from our families or the church. We were just Chris and RJ on our own and loving every minute of it. After some time, we faced the reality that we would eventually have to go home. I drove into Salt Lake, Chris's hometown. We agreed to take care of our respective loose ends, and he talked about transferring to Boise State with me. We kissed and said goodbye, and I went home to Idaho Falls. I never saw him again. I sent letters, I'd call, and nothing. If only I knew what happened to him, then maybe I'd have some closure. These days I live in Seattle. I'm neither Mormon nor Gentile. I was never formally excommunicated. I just stopped associating myself with the church at all. But I still wear my temple garments. I still have a food storage. And I still have a deep love for our Heavenly Father.
Okay, I'm gonna be late. You're gonna make me late.
You know I have somewhere else to be too.
I know. I have a meeting in like 30 minutes.
And?
You know I wrestled in high school and in college. Why not?
Loaded with sugar?
Well, I like sugar. Want some?
No.
You know, I'm nervous about tonight.
Don't be.
Are you sure they're ready for this?
No.
I think it's time they met us.
Mm-hmm.
I gotta go. I'm gonna be late.
Sorry I'm late. How long were you guys waiting?
Oh, just about 20 minutes.
Sorry.
Mom, Dad, this is Paul.
Such a pleasure to finally meet you.
It's nice to meet you, Paul.
Hi.
So nice to meet
you. Nice to meet you, too.
So, how was the flight?
Bumpy.
I see you found the rest of your party.
Yes, we did.
Can I get you some drinks?
I'll just have water.
I'll have a Diet Coke.
Okay, I'll be right back.
Thanks.
Diet Coke.
Yeah.
So, Mr. and Mrs. Smith, how long are you in town?
Just through Sunday evening.
We're just here for the weekend. We don't want to be in the way.
Dad, you're not in the way.
Well, I don't know. We never hear from you.
Tom.
No, I'm not trying to start anything. I'm just saying I wish I heard from my son more.
Okay.
I miss him.
Marianne calls at least once a week.
Okay, well, I'll check in more.
That would be nice.
So, Paul, what do you do?
I'm a personal trainer.
Oh, well, that's nice.
Paul's working on his MBA right now.
Really?
I keep telling RJ he should go for his master's.
I know, I say the same thing.
All right. Maybe at some point, but not right now.
Well, RJ, how is work going?
It's good, yeah. I'm not freelancing anymore, so I'm in the office a lot, but other than that, nothing too exciting. How's the shop, Dad?
It's good, actually. Going well. Can't complain.
You know, Mr. Smith, my father's actually a mechanic.
Really?
Yeah, he works primarily on Swedish automobiles.
Well, they're really well-made cars.
Yeah. I don't know.